Angel, 11 years, nearly 400 appearances, but your time as a Swans player is coming to an end. Must be a strange feeling for you.
It is a bit of a mixed feeling. First of all, obviously, very proud to have obviously played for 11 seasons for the club that gave me the opportunity to become a professional footballer and make my dream come true, which was obviously to become a Premier League footballer. I came as a League One player as a 24-year-old. And you can see 11 years after, you know, I've played more in the Premier League than in the other division. So in this aspect, you know, it's all pride and happiness, but at the same time, you know, sadness, because you never think this time is going to come. And years go by so fast, you don't realize. It's a very short career, and it's easy to say, but it actually happens. And the older you get, the more difficult it is to accept it. But, you know, you have to be realistic, and, you know, I have to... Again, be proud that I've achieved a lot with this club.
But you're not retiring, Angel. You want to carry on playing. Ideally, you would have done that at Swansea, I think, is how you feel. But now you're going to go and look to play somewhere else for a while.
Yes. Obviously, as I said, I'm realistic. I know this season has been difficult for me. I haven't had many games, you know, so obviously it's difficult for the club to give me another extension, you know, and I understand that. So I made it clear that I keep myself fit. I still feel good, and I will extend my career for as long as I can, or as long as my body can take it. So, I'll look somewhere else for hopefully one or two more seasons, and then about 37, 38, and it will be the time to call it, and hopefully I'll come back and obviously help the Swans in another way.
Yeah, whatever happens, you've said before that Swansea's your home now.
Mm-hmm.
You're not going back to Spain.
Maybe 6 months here, 6 months there.
Yeah. But you, wherever you go next, the plan is to come back to Swansea in whatever role it might be a bit further down the line.
Definitely. The base will be Swansea. You know, my wife is Welsh, my kids are Welsh, and I consider myself Welsh now. Simple as that. But for sure, I want to work for the club. I had already some conversations with Hugh Jenkins, and we did say that this is important, that the club keep... some obviously ex-footballers that have been part of the club, if you like, big part, because the last 10 years probably been one of the most shining years of the club. So being part of it again is a fantastic achievement, and I want to give that back to the club, maybe after playing football, in some knowledge, in some kind of role, and let's see what's there for me.
You touched on it there. You've been at this club in a fantastic period in Swans history. I'll take you back to 2007 when you joined. You didn't speak a word of English. You probably, I don't know, what did you think then? You'd perhaps be here for a year or two. What was your feeling when you came over? Roberto,
my challenge was to try a new adventure. So I came to Swansea, could have gone to Greece, and I decided to come to Swansea. And even though I knew more about Greece than I knew about Wales, I'm not going to lie. But I came to Swansea because I watched YouTube, I watched the Liberty Stadium, and when I saw the fans singing and how passionate they were, I thought that's the place to be. And Roberto obviously helped convincing me to come here. So I came here and I thought, if it doesn't work, look, I'll go back, I'll learn a bit of English, and I'll go back to Spain, and I'll stay in the division I was. Mm. Well, it did work differently, you know. Yeah. It worked well, and 11 years after, we're still sitting here and talking, and yeah, great.
That first season? I mean, you played every week practically.
Yes, that was one of the best, to be fair.
Won the league, one title, playing some great football.
I was named best right back in the league, the PFA team of the year, everything was great. And you could see the Swansea way was in place. And, you know, we had some fantastic games, even though in League One, you know, we played Leeds United, that 3-2 at home was a fantastic game. And it's just, I think, everything together was a fantastic setup. You know, even though we didn't have all these training grounds and we had all these, what you call it now, you know, big time, but we had that unity, we had that spirit, that team spirit, that football, everything that comes to be successful, and I think we nailed it. You know, I think we did 92 points, and it was just a joy to watch, a joy to play, and it was a great, great first season, definitely.
And then up to the Championship, question marks about every player, really, in the club, yourself, would you be able to cope with the step up
doubt,
to the next level? But that went pretty well as well, didn't it?
Yes, it did go well. I mean, the first year was always difficult because they were saying Swansea couldn't play the pretty football in such a difficult division. But we proved them wrong. We didn't get into the playoffs, but for sure we made a mark there where we showed that you can play. You can play, and we did change a few players, some went, some stayed, but it took us, 3 years to get to the playoffs and then get promoted. So those 3 years, I think, helped us not just as a team, I think as a club, to grow and realise how difficult the Championship is. And in the end, you just need that bit of luck, you know, and everything else together to obviously get that promotion. But yeah, still I think the Championship is a very difficult division, even more now, I think. But yeah, doing it and playing good football, I think, is double successful, if you like, and we achieved that.
And that the promotion season from the Championship, that must be some of your best memories from your 11 years in that season. Obviously, the Wembley final to end it all.
The Wembley final is one of the top moments. But I think you can't take away the 46 league games first, where with Brendan Rodgers as a manager, we played again fantastic football. Then in the semi-final, go to North Forest in the first leg, and then have a man sent off after 3 minutes. You think all season is over here, and we still managed to get a nil-nil draw, and then you play at home, and that atmosphere against North Forest, I think, is one of the best I've seen. Not even the Premier League when we play the big clubs, I've seen that, and it was fantastic when Darren Bradley scored that third goal. It was just madness, and that's one of the moments he'll stay with you forever, you know. And then obviously after that, when you're going to Wembley, the confidence was just in the sky.
When Reading got back to 3-2, the confidence taking a bit of a dent there.
We did say half-time after 3-0, we say, it's not over. You know, you try to convince yourself, it's not over. But inside yourself, you think, well, 3-0,
it's over.
You know. But yeah, when they scored the second, you could see, like, it was difficult. They hit the post, and that block from Gary Monk was just a 90 million block, you know. And that sealed it for us. We knew, like, scoring one more was over. We did that, and the dream come true, and it was a fantastic day then.
And the Premier League, very much like the step up to the Championship, everybody on the outside said, well, Swansea aren't going to be able to play good football. These players probably aren't going to make it at Premier League level. But again, individually and collectively, you proved them wrong.
I mean, it showed you the foundations were built from League One. It wasn't a coincidence. It was a project of 4 years where the most important thing was the recruitment team. I think they brought in fantastic players that suited the Swansea way. And we weren't afraid of anything. And that was what Brendan made sure Will had as a mindset. You know, go and play the games, very positive, always look after the ball and make them chase it. And you could see that, especially in that first season, the possession was just ridiculous. I remember getting a message with newspaper article showing me that I was the player with most touches of the ball in the Premier League in the season, above Luka Modric, Yaya Toure, and I was thinking, that's a right back. Like, how is that possible? And it shows you that the way of playing was, let's play from the back, from the goalkeeper, and everybody touches the ball, and we don't kick it long. And it was exactly that, you know, where it doesn't matter who you played against, when you're having a good day and looking after the ball, we would have a chance to win. And we stayed in the league quite comfortably that year.
Next year was pretty good too. Another trip to Wembley, another good day out.
It was a step up the following season, you know. I know we changed managers. Michael came in, and it was a slightly different football, but at the same time, I think it was more what you can call maybe heavy metal football. Not as much possession, but more effective and still looking after the ball. You know, we brought in a lot of more Spanish players at the time, and you could see it was a fantastic season. Top 10, we played against I think it was West Brom at home. I think those first 45 minutes were the best I've played and I've seen in a Swansea shirt. I think so, I think so. Even though the Wembley final, the first 45 were really good, but I think that one at home was pretty special. And then going to Wembley, obviously, for the final of the Cup is another special moment. But I take probably the semi-final away when we beat Chelsea 2-0. That was, I think, as special as the final, you know, because when you win 5-0, sometimes you just don't get as excited as beating Chelsea away. But yeah, I mean, it was a fantastic season again.
Europa League followed as a result of that Wembley win.
What an experience.
Some more great nights, particularly Valencia away, when I think you captained the team,
for the first time.
Remember, that was the first one.
The first one, another top moment.
That must have been something for you, back home in Spain.
Well, I live about an hour and a half away from Valencia, so I had about 60 people from my hometown, you know, my family included, and it was a great day. 30 degrees, the sun was out. The Swans team had more Spanish players than the Valencia team, so you could see we were the better team already. And the 3-0, I mean, the football we played that day, you know, against a big club. History-wise, Valencia are a big club, and we went there and we smashed them. So another tough moment. Unfortunately, we didn't go through more stages in the Europa League against Napoli, which I think we deserve more.
Yeah.
We could have probably made a bit more, you know, history there. But again, what a year. I think you feel a better player when you play in Europe, and it did. It did certainly feel that.
The best Premier League finish in terms of points and league position was under Gary Monk.
Mm-hmm.
Your memories of that season?
It was a fantastic season. It wasn't that pretty to watch, but it was very effective, and we got the points because I think we had a fantastic structure in how to defend and attack, and it was I think very effective.
In the meantime, wherever you go and play next, I've no doubt that you're going to be straight on your phone after games and seeing how the Swans have got on, aren't you?
Well, definitely. I mean, these days, with the social media and apps and all of that, I think it's easy to see all the scores and stuff. So for sure, the first team I'll check after my games will be Swansea, always, and Barcelona, of course.
Yeah, but this is your club, isn't it, Angel? I mean, it goes without saying, really.
It is. You know, I've been lucky enough to be a footballer for Swansea, but also I'll be a fan now. And I always want Swansea to do well, try to finish in the division as high as possible, and hopefully, after football, be able to watch them every week, be a season ticket holder and support them, and obviously enjoy the games watching the Swansea way again.
You're a Jack Angel these days.
Jack B, yeah, definitely.
Great stuff. Thanks, mate.
Thank you.